So I've got an update for Territorians on the COVID-19 pandemic. There was 2 new cases of COVID-19 diagnosed in the territory overnight, and both of these are linked to the current cluster, which now stands at 63. And I'll just provide some details around those 2 cases for the community. Both cases, importantly, were in quarantine when they tested positive, and both are linked to the 3-year-old that was diagnosed earlier in the week from Acacia Road in Katherine. The first was the mother of the 3-year-old. She tested negative on December 5th, on Sunday, but she's since returned a positive test. And she has been in quarantine with the 3-year-old in Royal Darwin Hospital, so a very low risk to the community with her diagnosis. The second is an infant child who is a household contact of the 3-year-old girl. So as we explained, it was a family grouping, extended family. And so an infant has now tested positive there. So we wish the mother and the infant all the best in a speedy recovery. We've got 18 tests back from the 31 people that are in quarantine that have been associated with this 3-year-old. 2 of those were positive, 16 are negative, and we're just waiting on those outstanding results. So we'll report them to the community as soon as we get them. We do expect possibly some more positive cases, but those people are all in appropriate quarantine, as I understand. And so we'll certainly update the community as we get those results. There was 2,974 tests conducted in the territory yesterday, and around 200, just under 200 were in Katherine. So I thank everybody that's come forward to be tested. That's really important territory-wide. We do know that we've got COVID in our community, and as much as people think they may have no association to Katherine, we do need anyone with symptoms to come forward, please. And we also did some targeted testing around Acacia Road in Katherine. So I thank our frontline workers who've been out there doing that, door knocking and visiting households to ensure that people are being provided with that opportunity to be tested. And we certainly have testing resources in Katherine available for the community. So we will keep that focus on the Katherine region. The other aspect that we've been updating the community on regularly is the wastewater testing. And I can report that wastewater testing for Bicentennial Road has come back showing a presence of COVID, but it is less than previously detected. So that looks like that we've identified these cases, and with those people no longer being in that catchment, we're seeing that reduce. So those signal strengths have declined, and we're hopeful to see that continue over the coming days. I do want to warn the community, though, that we will see people returning from the Centre for National Resilience back into Katherine, and they will continue to shed the virus. And so we may get detections of COVID, a presence in the wastewater, which won't necessarily be linked to new cases and people turning positive. It could be those previous cases shedding the virus. So it's certainly an important tool for us, and Dr. Payne can speak to that in our management of COVID, but it will certainly not necessarily point to cases that we're unaware of. It could be people shedding that virus. There's 216 close contacts at present associated with this cluster. All are in isolation, and we've got around 20 tests still remaining from those close contacts. So we're working to get those returned. And as I've said continually, if they do come back positive, we'll update the community. In terms of people in hospital, there's 3 people in Royal Darwin Hospital presently. We have the gentleman in his 50s who was in intensive care. He's still recovering on the ward, but still in hospital, and we wish him all the best and thank those staff that have been caring for him. We have the 3-year-old child that was diagnosed earlier in the week that is in hospital, and that 3-year-old child's mother has been an escort in hospital, so she has now turned positive. So we've got 3 people in Royal Darwin Hospital, but 2 are there for their clinical care, and the 3rd is an escort. So we wish all of them the best. And just before I hand to Dr. Payne to make some comments, I do need to update the community that tragically we had a death in the Centre for National Resilience last night, and it was not COVID related, but tragically for that family, an individual has passed away, a woman in her 50s. And we, of course, extend our sympathy and condolences to her family. The matter, because it was an unexpected death within a government facility, appropriate steps have been taken. It has been, the coroner has been notified, and there'll also be an internal review, but very tragic that individual has passed away, and I extend my condolences to her family and community. So I'll hand to Dr. Payne, and then both of us are happy to answer any questions. Thank you.
Thank you, Minister. Thank you, everyone. Just want to say a little bit about Catherine. Firstly, we've got these two new cases. We do expect to have more. We've got three households, as we know, that were close household contacts of the first case that we notified you a couple of days ago. So we do expect more results to come back over the next few days. So just in relation to the community in that area, there is a group of our staff going door to door to encourage people to be tested and, of course, to be vaccinated. Can I ask you to please support them and cooperate with them? Testing is really important at this stage. As we do expect further cases, it's very important that we identify them now over these next few days. The other thing is, please, again, appeal to you to get vaccinated if you haven't had your first vaccine anywhere in the territory now. It's a very important time. We need to, now, if anyone hasn't still making their mind up to get vaccinated at all, now is the time. Come forward, get your first vaccine. It will give you significant protection. And if you're waiting to get your second vaccine, come forward and get that, and you will get very good protection from your second vaccine. In Catherine, please use QR codes, particularly now. It's very important that if we do have further cases, that we are able to identify people who have been in contact early on. It helps us tremendously with our contact tracing. So it's very important in Catherine, but everywhere in the territory, please, just make it a matter of routine. It's easy. We all know how to do it. We've all got our phones to do that. Please check in using the QR code. Other than that, I'd just like to thank the community in Catherine for all of their cooperation and their support during this difficult time for them, and we wish them that well for the next few weeks.